report, Matt. Denver is still in the running, but it has gotten more complicated. First off, let's walk you again through the controversy. This is where they want to put the museum. You can see it's in the shadow of the state capitol downtown, the corner of Lincoln and Colfax. But it's this piece of land right here, currently controlled by RTD, that's a source of controversy. The museum, they want this land. They want to put a park here. RTD, so far, unwilling to give it to them. Now, last night, 7 board members voted against giving the museum the land near RTD's main bus terminal downtown for $123,000 a year. Some board members said it's worth more money. Others claimed, why should Medal of Honor recipients need so much land? Well, last night it looked like the project might be dead, but the governor, Jared Polis, isn't giving up, and neither are city council members. They're looking for a solution to RTD.
I actually spoke with a couple of the board members this morning, and it sounds like the biggest thing for them is just lack of information. They feel like they should be informed in the decisions that they make. I recognize that we live in a world of economics, but in this case, it's important for us to have a national celebration for these 3,200 folks.
Councilman Chris Hines there, and a statement was sent by Joe Daniels, the museum CEO. Remember, Denver's competing against Arlington, Texas for this national museum. Daniels telling us, we continue to evaluate Denver and Arlington as the two finalist cities and remain on track to make a final announcement next month. Now, just within the last few hours, we learned RTD will likely re-vote on this proposal sometime later this month before that big vote of the national board. So it will likely depend on public pressure at this point and lobbying. We should know by the first week in October if Denver is selected. Joe St. George, Fox 31.
Yeah, we'll wait for the update.